Okay. Hi, welcome back. So week two with Amanda. Amanda, thanks for coming back. She came back. Week two, that's awesome. So one of the big drills we left with last time that she worked on this week was this rotational drill. And that's just basically to help her body move better, which in the end, we want our body to support kind of what our arms are doing. And that's how we end up getting the hip swell longer and whatever like that. So when we have good support of our body. So the drill setup system that Amanda showed you, where first off, we're going to put this about 4 feet away. And the reason I managed to do this is she was kind of starting down with both of the upper body and lower body at the same time. And so this week you're working on like what with this drill? What was the big points?
Getting that front hip back and parallel with the back hip and then to follow through.
Oh, that was awful. Like, I know when I told you at the beginning, I was like, this is crazy.
It's a weird feeling. Yeah. Definitely a weird feeling, but practicing it 15 to 20 minutes a day, I'm getting the hang of it.
Good.
So to kind of start with it and to kind of keep that fluid motion has been helpful.
Good. And so one thing I want to point out, so the 15 minutes a day that man is doing or more, that is like the number that I've come up with. But even when I practice, I do 25 or 50 reps of it, something a day, because I go crazy with 15 minutes. I like look at the clock and I see tick, 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 tick. So folks, you can do either. Either of them work, find 25 to 50 reps and you can do it morning or night. Or if you like 15 minutes, do 15 minutes. Both can be done. Okay. So yeah, Amanda had worked on when we transition from up here in our golf swing, we want to be one or left side, but we want to start our downswing with feeling this left hip go back. We don't want this right hip going flying out. Then we end up really saying everything. So this is the drill Amanda was working on. We're going to put this stick about 4 feet away from her. And she's going to get into posture and kind of show you how she does it here. Good backswing. That's a huge change. So when doing this thing, make sure you have something in front of you like a mirror so you can make sure your head is not getting too far back. And I said that's the big thing. You have the other feedback mechanism of this. So, yeah, one more time here. We had Amanda's skill, like you have kind of a laser out of this thing, tracing this or whatever.
Get that front head of the club or the laser, as you mentioned, keeping it with that blue line.
Perfect.
And then keeping that back.
So see it. And you're trying to stay up a little bit too. And then talk about feeling yourself dipping a little bit too. So that's good. Back good. Good. So I want you to get your full back so I can stop again. So your full back good. Now when you feel just a little shift left. So you feel more pressure on your throat. There you go. Now push back and go. All right. And I think that's the big thing is just making sure the full swing. We're here. We've gotten to our left side. Then we push back. Okay. And you're doing this. Yeah, perfect.
Yeah.
You're doing that really good.
I feel it.
That is not an easy move, but you keep kind of adding pushing this back. And rotation. So really good. Okay. Okay. So back here with Amanda, we're going to take a look at her swing and kind of see what I notice here. First off, like, you know what? Amanda's got a very athletic swing. Like, you played Division
III
soccer, right?
Yes.
All 4 years?
Correct.
Yeah, so that's pretty awesome.
And I did caddy growing up all throughout high school, so I've been around golf. Good. I just haven't been playing itself. So.
Yeah, okay, awesome. Now, what do you do athletic? Like, do you work out now?
Yep, I go for a lot of runs, and then I do, like, yoga, Pilates, bar type. So, a lot of things with my hips, which is why it's a little bit more flexible there, too.
Good. Okay, cool. Okay, so we're going to look at the down-the-line view, kind of see first what she's doing. Like, this is awesome. It's kind of on her hands, the club, which I'm looking at. She's not opening it wide open here, as you can see, which is really good. It goes up the plane. Amanda's swing on the plane is really, really good. Like, if you look at this thing, look, it goes up the plane perfectly. And she has one of these things that I'm always very jealous of with people with long arms tall, because this will create a lot of power in the end. So you're, you know, basically 90 degrees here. You could have that arm a little more up, but it's perfect. But the height that you're creating with your hands is super important, because a lot of people can't do that. Especially, like, we lose, the older we get, we can't do it as much, but you just have those really long arms. That's going to be a huge advantage for you in the future to really gain a lot of power, which you're going to have with your strength. We just have to. I'll show you why you lose it. So you see her butt pushes back here, which we want. We want her butt gaining a little depth there, pushing back. So we'll look at the face on here. So, but I just want to show her the plane, how good it is coming down. So on the way down, see, she comes down right along here. So the club's basically coming a little bit from the inside, and Amanda like draws the ball. So here, contact a little behind. Now, what we're going to talk about here a little bit too, is I look at impact here. I could probably get confused with address. See, there's not a huge difference, right? What we want to see is more the body more cleared out of the way. So supporting you a little different, that means your body was used a little more, so just the arms. And it makes sense not to know really how to do that. So And we'll kind of see part of the reason that happens here. So you rotate nicely, you get to the top. I would say this, if we look at this right here, by the time we get to the top of the backswing, I want you to kind of like recenter, meaning back more on your left side. And I kind of want to see where you're at right here.
So the middle of my body should be more?
Yeah, so if I just look at pressure when you go here, if you talk about where you start, let's just say you're 50-50 here. When we get to the top, you're doing pretty good, but I'd say you have a little more on your back foot.
Okay.
Like others, it's just like there's a little more staying on this back side instead of being a little more like this.
Okay.
Okay, so we're just going to push a little bit more this way, just a tad bit. And you can see why it is you're outside this line, just a little bit.
Okay.
Which it's okay in the back swing to come a little bit out, but we eventually want to work back to right on that line. That way you're going to be more ready on the way down. And the problem that it causes casting, if we're just starting with our hands and stuff, is we want the lower body working more as you're doing in the drill, right? We just have to transfer that, right? And so when I mean casting this, when this puck comes down, there's this gap between your thigh and hands. Like we are going to work, and this is your distance thing. You talk about the clubs all being the same distance. We're going to work on when this club's, your hands are right here, they're actually over your thigh. Like we're going to close this distance like a lot.
Okay.
But for that to happen, and this is what we're going to work on, we have to, you're doing a movement called casting at the top like this. And it's one of the ways to close the club face on the way down. Everybody has to close club face on the way down. Some people do it like this. The others like will rotate like this. And I'll show you another way. But this is a massive loss of power doing it this way. And that's why we have to get rid of it. It's just the way you figured out. And most golfers have figured out how to close club face. And it's just, but the problem is it's not powerful because you see how you drag behind. And then you get here, you have to throw it back. Now, this is where I can tell how athletic she is because she still gets her hands a little bit ahead at impact because she knows that's going to help her hit the ball good or better, right? So that's a really athletic move when you have that much casting to still have your hands ahead. So that's really good. We just have to help you back here a little more. Yeah, okay. You have great structure, which I know we worked on last time a bit with this more straighter structure, which is awesome. So that's really good. I want to look at you if we can notice how you do with the pushing back if you start with it. I would guess no because you cast. And see, you can see they start at the same time. So your downswing, watch this one starts. You see your hip and hands go at the same time, together together. So in order to sequence properly, we're going to have the hands kind of stay up here. Well, this is happening first.
So hip first and then hands?
Yeah.
Okay.
So sequencing is basically we want, when we're unwinding, the lower body goes basically first, right? Then you have your thorax, then it's arms, and then the last thing goes hands.
Okay.
You go hands and body together, which is why you end up like this. Okay. And so we're just going to get in why that, how to stop that. So we're going to do some drills now to start working on that. And then we're going to, I think, end with that drill. But also I want to talk to Amanda a little bit about playing golf and how she can strike the ball better while playing and the difference between playing golf and practicing. After looking at Matt's swing, we want to talk a little bit more about the move that she makes from the top of casting like this. You see this big gap right here. And, you know, she mentioned to me earlier, too, that she has trouble with getting distance from her 6, 7, 8, 9 with them all being close to the same. A lot of it is just this casting move. Now, when we cast, it's a way to close the club face. So everybody on the way down has to close the club face one way or another face right here, right? So one way of doing it is to go like this and then look how your club face closed. I want you to start thinking of the club face closing more because we rotate it a little bit like this and then see how this happens. That's too much, but just so you feel it. On the way down, the professional, the good players, they rotate this and their wrist will get more like this. It's called motorcycle move. So then they can rotate through more and get the shafting that we want. So we're going to work on how do we feel this move, right? And then how do we kind of practice it, okay? So motorcycle move and then just sequencing in general. Okay, so let's talk about that at first. So I want you to take your grip on the club and then I just want you to take it up about halfway. Three quarters back. Good. Okay, so you're riding pretty flat here. So if you come down here, rotate. We want to learn to get right here.
Okay.
Yep. So go. Let's see you go up again. So you already go up and you don't have any cup in your wrist at all right here. So you, like, you don't even really have to twist this more because you're already there, right? Most of you folks out there are going to have to twist it, okay? So when you get back here, I want you to think of something too about that. We're going to be brought right here. So when you come down, your first move is it goes like this, your wrist.
That's why it's so far away.
Yeah. Okay. So see this right here in the trail wrist?
Mm-hmm.
We want that. So start with your hip pushed back, and then this goes more here. So we're going to work on that move real slowly first. So Amanda's just going to go like this, swing up to about here. She's going to make sure she's more on her left side. She's going to push back with her hip really slow, and then practice getting like this.
It's not there.
Yep. Good. Now, you have good push back right there. Yeah. And barely behind your hands. The other thing I want you to think of is how I'm, like, when I'm here, it was like this hip's more out of the way, like I'm pretty close to impact. Yeah, good. When you get to here, so that's more out of the way.
Okay.
And you're right there. And that's, you don't have to turn down that much. Yeah. So not right there. Okay, good. Let's see that again. Just, you're going really super slow on this too. Good. Nice. Push back. And there you go. Yeah. And so push this hip back a little bit. There you go.
Okay.
Yeah. And then keep your head down basically right there. Good. That's perfect right there. Good. Let's have you turn, like, face this way so people see it all the way around. Right? Yeah, no, yeah, all the way around. So you're facing here. Yeah,
sorry. Perfect.
Good. Good. And then you'll be able to kind of see yourself in this mirror, too, doing it. Good.
I think I'm
good. Get that hinge. So, yeah, one of the main things we do on the back swing is getting this wrist in, which you did good now. So make sure you're going locked up, push back good. Yeah. Here, stay in front of you. Get that leg a little more straight. There you go. So remember that straight line we talked about, shoulder, hip, and that?
Okay.
So right there, yeah. So you're good right there. That's okay. Awesome. So that's the new feeling you have to add in that we're trying to do. And the club is staying a little more behind your hands, like right here. Yeah, good, good. Let's see, do it a couple more times. Good. And your goal is to be stop there. And I'm going to make one other move. Like when you do this, back foot is kind of just rolled in a little bit, just like that. So a little shift. Good. Now push back. Good. And I would just really separate it. So I'd be here, right? I should look to my left side, and I push back, and then I go really slow down.
Really? Okay. Yeah, yep. I think I'm doing it at the same time again. So.
Yeah. Oh, good. Little shift. Hold these up while you shift. Hold that. Now push back. And go. Good. Yeah. There you go. Good. I think the hard thing is also you're going to feel like doing this, that this lead shoulder kind of stays down. Doesn't go up right away.
Okay.
So we go up, we kind of tilt this way.
Okay.
Let's have you face like this way now, kind of so you can see it from this way, facing the camera. If you don't mind, thank you for it. I think that'll be a good view to see you getting into how far in front you get.
So.
Good. Shift, push back. And yeah, the only thing you want to watch is this lead shoulder. So your lead shoulder is going like up like that.
So stay down.
So yeah, watch how mine works. If I push back here, see how it's staying more like this.
Okay.
So I want your chest, when we get to this position, pointing up here. See how down it is like this?
Okay.
Not up.
Okay.
Yeah. See how it goes from. So you're getting a good hinge on the way back. Good. So that push back, man. Yeah. And then this is going to be a little more in tight on you. Good. Right there. Good. And then push back a little bit with your head. Yeah. Your leg's almost going to be straight by that. That's pretty good.
Okay.
I'm going to do one more thing. Make sure you're not getting out on that toe because we want our hip to stay back. So you're going to feel like you're almost like rolling in that back foot a lot. I know this is a lot, but by doing this is going to be a big, good drill for me in practice. Push back good. Shoulders stay down.
I can feel it in my face.
Yep.
Okay.
So this shoulder's gonna go down as you pull forward. Good, 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 good. Keep it down. Good. There you go. Good. And then I would say just make sure you're staring at where the ball would be.
Yeah.
So your head stays in the right spot. Well, it's only 52 things. You know what I mean? So push back, go. Let's see it there. And then push that a little bit more back to you there.
And then
this stays behind you.
Yeah.
So this is what we're gonna work on this drill here and kind of see where it goes, and then we'll come back here with you in a bit. All you want on the practice swing, right? And you're going to get in front of it, too. Make sure you land in front. If not, you got to do it again. Good. Did you land in front?
I think so.
Okay. We're going to do it again.
Practice one
more thing. Try again. To land down. So, lead shoulder may have to go down more to get you there. Let the shoulder go down. So you can go down as you come through. As you come through, there you go. Now you got it. There you go. Sometimes the shoulder gets up too high on the way down.
Okay.
You're going to have trouble getting down. You got to feel like just that starts with it. Try one more press.
Okay.
Just try to kind of dive into it a little bit with your lead shoulder. There we go. Perfect. Now, this next one, you're going to think about just sitting in front, okay? I would take that all day long. It started out a little bit right and had about a 4-yard draw. Perfectly solid. Good job.
Oh, it's all good.
Way to go. Okay. So thanks for watching and thanks for doing this. Yeah. Awesome.
10 to 15 minutes or 50-ish reps a day.
That's it.